Hi guys, DevilHunterXYZ, and we're back with Bloodstained Curse of the Moon 2. Yeah, so, still at episode 1, just got my hands into stage 3. And of course we just uncovered another character, Robert, kind of an expert marksman. Raging Chariot. I think I might have to use Robert for a little bit. Pretty quick shot for Robert, although his health is even less than Dominique's, so gotta have to be careful here. Try it. Oop. Get off the stairs. Don't give me that Castlevania problem. I had to try to be accurate with the shots, kind of like Mega Man in a way. I can't really go down, unfortunately. So far. Alright, at least I got a checkpoint. Got my charm once again. Actually, do they even have names for these? Magic charm, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I forgot I found out that pressing the pause can actually bring up the menu and let you see what sub-weapons you have. Oh god. Thank you. And I can't... Actually, maybe I could reach there. I don't know. Not bad. Oh, kind of a fail right there. Hit points up. Is that really considered hit points when you don't actually have points? Alright. Demon Essence powers up attacks for a short time while low on versatility. The extra power can defeat enemies in one hit. That normally takes two. Raise the shield.
Okay.
Oh boy. All these new weapons, I don't know. The D cannon. By crawling, Robert can avoid even low trajectory attacks. This crawling attack well suited to them. Oh, give the tips. Fires a powerful but high cost piercing shot forward. Its recoil can change Robert's jump trajectory. Is that a good thing or not? Another mine car type boss. Be dead. Oh my god. Another ram attack. Oof. Almost there though. Wow. Dang, I'm strong. Better life. I remember you. It's been a long time. What sort of device is that? Fall back, Zangetsu. This must be the work of alchemists. We can't trust it. Not every alchemist is evil, Robert. It appears to have done all of this just so we could try to find me. Damn it. This is a mistake. We will regret this. Hachi has become an ally. So strange, a dog is now a part of the team. A dog riding a giant mechanical, I don't know what, a mechanical juggernaut of armor? Armor destruction. Okay. Death from above, square down mid-air, okay. Steam hover, hold X. While step ignores some floor effects. Invincibility iron, turn on or off with your weapons, uses weapon points. Okay. So, Hachi doesn't really have any special weapons per se, but Hachi has kind of a good abilities, making him like an iron tank. Queen's Dirge. Alright, stage 4. I said the hover is a little bit on the sensitive side. Maybe because I'm so used to platform jumping and retro-style games like this by holding down the X button, but gotta remember not to hold it down, otherwise I have to hover. What's down here anyway? Ooh. Something's here. I think this might be for another episode, just thinking about it. I don't know. Being able to crush through spikes really helps. Whoa. Gonna have to fall here. Thank you. Alright. Not sure where I'm even going at this point. Oh god. Other sharpshooters as well. That's nice. Oh. Oh no, so close. Another one of these. How much more of this ice palace do I have to go through? Gonna be dead soon. Got more weapon points again, that's good. Hey, at least I'm at 40. Actually, I'm kind of wondering if they did increase the max or not. I don't know. Because 40 was the max you could have gotten in for weapon points in the first game. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get through this fight. Oh hey, isn't that the same mermaid boss from Ritual of the Night, the very first one you fight? So I guess they did take some bosses from that game. Oh no. Hachi blew up. I don't have much to deal with right now. Honestly, I think it'd be better off if I just kill off my teammates. I mean, I have 5 lives anyway. Oh, I'm not that far off. Get thrown in this part. Hurry, my invincibility frames aren't gonna help me that much. Oh shoot. Get these stupid frogs off of me. Thank you. Okay. Let's try what that is. Hand grenade. Up to the ground, rolls forward. Grenades can't bounce off walls to hit enemies from behind. Okay. This may not go so great. No one cares about even has good health, it's probably Hachi. But unfortunately, Hachi is not that mobile. Just keep using your strength. Alright. Good enough. Oh, wow. I'll actually have blood in Bloodstained. Oh, of course, a second fight. Just brute force your way through it. It works, I guess. Ooh, a sword. You got the soul eraser. Okay. The Soul Eraser is a cursed blade capable of obliterating the souls of good and evil alike. Only a true master can unleash its full potential. Slash combo, that's good. The Helm Splitter. Soul Domination powers up all sub-weapons. Okay. So in a weird way, it's almost like... In the original Curse of the Moon, there was like an alternate playthrough where if you encounter your comrades in the beginning of the game, you could essentially kill them and retrieve their souls, and that basically gives you certain power-ups. So that's kind of pretty cool, actually, that they have something close to this right here. Looks like they extended the range of the whip. Ooh, wow. I'm guessing to make the demon essence maybe stronger and longer. Alright. Well, actually, I think for that, I'm gonna probably leave it as is. So, I mean, so far, not too bad. Got what I needed to get so far. I'm kind of guessing there's gonna be like 8 stages or so, 8 or 9 stages, probably. So, I'm probably almost at the halfway point in this game. Granted, episode 1, because I'm pretty sure there's gonna be a lot of episodes. I'd wait and see on that. Alright guys, this is DevilHunterXYZ, and until next time.